I'm in Hanover today at Conte, where I'm going to meet Carla, and she's head of a project that is quite unexpected.
Hi, Mikaela. Nice to meet you.
Let's go over there.
How can we see the rubber then in these roots, the dandelion
roots? We can try to to break it, and not too much, just very, very carefully, and then to see the rubber in between. You see it? Yeah.
Okay, so that is the rubber.
That is the rubber, this tiny white bands in between.
So this means pretty much if I just harvest my dandelions at home and I will give them to you, you will get rubber for the tires?
No.
No.
We don't want to have them because they do not have any rubber in the roots.
Okay. Yeah. So it's like a special type of dandelion.
It's a Russian dandelion, which has just the possibility and the chance to make rubber in its root.
Okay. What are then, if you compare to natural rubber that we are used to in the tires, what is then the positives with the dandelion rubber?
The rubber tree itself just only grows in the tropical area, where also rainforest is growing.
Yeah.
And dandelion is growing more or less everywhere where you have moderate climate zones. So we have much more area where we are able to cultivate. And for increasing demands, you also have not the pressure anymore on the rainforest, because you need more acreage for growing natural rubber. And then you can do it in other areas where it's not that sensitive.
When do you believe that it will be possible to get all the rubber from all these dandelions to actually produce a function tire?
I guess we start doing that in the next 5 to 10 years.
Wow, that's really cool. Okay, I want to be the first one to try those.